Republican congressional candidate Kevin Yoder talked about his refusal to take a field breath test last year during a traffic stop.
He was on a conservative radio talk show, but he refused to talk to Channel 9.
Commitment 2010 coverage tonight with KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney.
Yoder had already been scheduled to appear on KMBZ's The Darla Jay Show. He is in the headlines because he refused to take a breath test, a field breath test, during an early morning traffic stop in 2009. Now, the Douglas County DA's office considers that refusal an obstruction to a DUI investigation, and Yoder pled guilty to that, not taking the test. And he was ready to talk about it on the radio, but not to us.
The district attorney's office says that they regarded what you did as an obstruction of a DUI investigation. Do you have a comment on that?
Come on, guys.
Do you have a comment on that, Kevin? Kevin, one more time. The DA's office said what you did was an obstruction of a DUI investigation. No comment?
I think it's important that I'm here today answering questions about it. I want to be as forthright and open on this issue as we can.
Court records show that very early on Sunday morning, February the 8th, 2009, Yoder was stopped for speeding on K-10 Highway. He was accused of doing 80 in a 70-mile-an-hour zone. Now, Yoder passed a field sobriety test from a state trooper, and since he passed that, he refused to take the preliminary breath test known as a PBT.
That's right. You have a right not to participate in that PBT test.
That's true. But the Douglas County DA's office, which handled the case, says they regarded that as an obstruction of a driving under the influence investigation, and therefore we require a guilty plea to that charge. And that's what Yoder did. Pled guilty to refusing the test. He was fined $90. The speeding charge was dismissed. He was not charged with drunk driving.
In the radio interview, Yoder blamed the Moore campaign for bringing up the issue in the final week of the race. Actually, the story was first reported by the Capital Journal newspaper in their Sunday edition. Micheal Mahoney, KMBC 9 News.